Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Am I recording? Yeah, fellow acolytes and Divinity 2 interested people, we're back with another episode. And yeah, we just came out of the Vault of Brachus Rex. Found the ring. And found out that apparently the thing inside us is a god. If I understand that correctly. At least, it proclaims to be a god. Oops. So we cannot know if it's true.
Careful now, that's a trap.
Interesting. Okay. I just wanted to pick that flower. A shield is not really what we need. Unidentified gloves. Let's see. Fist percussion. Plus one two-handed. Oh yeah, she has the gloves of teleportation. Well, then I will certainly take them. And probably equip them as well. Since I'm the tanky girl in our party. Give me that flower. Alright. Okay, so what is there to do now? I didn't see that digging spot in the first place. Second skin.
Lucky find.
Ring of the Intelligence. Mask of Strange. Oh, alright. It's a unique item, and it was covered with, well, whatever did poison. Plus one finesse. I had these 5-8 and these are 6-8. Plus one finesse, plus 10 poison resistance, plus one huntsman. And finesse grants me 5% damage. That's hard. Alright, intelligent and poison resistance. You have the restoration ring and the unfinished ring. Take the intelligence ring. And I'll take the unfinished ring. Alright. Nice. Okay, so what to do? Let's check the quest log. If the ring was actually what we had to bring. So apparently not. Well, last time I said I wanted to explore the rest of the map. So I guess we are just going to do that. Like climbing up there. What's up here? Ah, this is the GPU killing stuff. There is tools. There were some chests And there were some undying pigs. Alright. Well, let's go this way. I bet we are risking getting attacked up here. Let's be careful about this place. Yeah, we were there. We were at the other side of that. Oh, this is Brekka's armory. So this wasn't Brekka's armory. It was his vault. Okay. So let's not go into that cave for now. Or ruin. Okay, can we climb down here or do we need a druid? It seems we can climb down here. Okay, there's an ice surface. Oh my god. There is a dragon. So normally you would need the pet pole to talk with animals. So we are 2 levels away from our next talent point.
The stone gargoyle trains glistening agate eyes upon you. Its jaws creak open, raining dust as it begins to speak.
Okay.
You are not Brekka's Rex.
That's true. But I can show you the ring of the Source King.
Welcome home, master.
Alright. Why not?
Stern eyes and a sterner face stare into your very soul. Under the inescapable gaze, you begin to shiver uncontrollably.
Another crawling rat, tracking your stinking paws beneath my nose. Vermin are not tolerated in my house. Begone!
Let's bow. Because Brekka's Rex was a very powerful person. So let's show some respect.
Do not doubt my power. I merely wish you gone. You are gone. Be gone!
And outside. Alright. And now I'm back in. But not where the statue was. Interesting. There we were. Huh. I hope I did not mess up our only chance. It seems it's just a maze. So
oh, it's stuck fast. I'll need something to prise it open.
There's a pressure plate. Oh, there's something. A crumbling skull.
Careful, I've spotted a trap. Careful now, that's a trap.
Okay, now and with this skull I can do exactly what? There's a ways. Perhaps I have to give it to this thing? There's a hedge. I'm not good at puzzling, I tell you that much. So this could take a while. Can I get me that per telekinesis? No. Okay, so we cannot climb down. I mean, I could crack these doors or attack them.
These skulls crumbled to dust after one use.
Oh, I see.
The gargoyle stirs, the dust of millennia drifting from its pocked wings.
Many have come this way. Few have survived. I invite you to join them.
All right. So I guess we have to go inside this hedge. Well, at least we found some gold. And this is an illusionary door. So it's not really there. Well, again, it's a force field.
I've spotted a trap.
Oh, nice.
Careful now. That's a trap.
There's another. There is another plate which opens this door. Only for a few seconds though. Oh, what's with you? You're the historian. And there is Source. Oh no. A noxious bulb. Do you think we can burn off the oil? I don't want to carry an oil barrel. I just want to move it around. Oh! Alright. Okay. Let's separate again. So Sibyl can go.
Look out! I see a trap nearby.
Can go there. And.
Careful now, that's a trap.
Yes, thank you. Will this fire go away? I hope so. One turn, it says. Oh, and since these are oil wells, I guess they will explode every now and then. Okay, so let's get this ways. Because I think sticking an oil barrel Do I have a trap disarming kit?
A trap. Better give it a wide berth.
No. Okay. Let's check back here. There's anything useful? There's another chest with nothing in it, but perhaps I can use the chest. Cannot pick it up. Okay. Oh, there is a torture chair. Shall we sit in it? Didn't really do anything. There is another torch.
Careful now, that's a trap.
Okay, torch is lit. Now let's try to sit in that chair. Nothing happened though. Alright. Then let's come back through here.
Careful! I spotted a trap.
And... wasn't this door open before? Oh no, I see these two. Oh, okay. She will walk all the way back. This is closed, this is closed. Perhaps I did mess it up. This definitely belongs to this beach. And there's a cave with a skull symbol, though. So, perhaps this will give something to me. This door is closed now. Yeah. What if I place the oil barrel there? Have to be careful though, because one fireball and this oil barrel is dead and I'm locked. Okay. Now us two are inside this. Oh, there's another torch, and there too, as well.
Look out! I see a trap nearby.
Okay, now I lit every torch in here. And there is the pressure plate we needed. All right. Yeah, the torches had nothing to do with it. All right. So let's have Sybil do this. Ah, this is a problem.
Careful now, that's a trap.
Yeah. God damn it. Okay, I got this guy. Okay, so the skull opens the door for us. So let's just open that door. Oh, I'm dumb. I was out, so I could have stood upon the pressure plate to open the door again. So do we have this car now? Nope. Skull. One of us has to go out now. Mm. Okay. So where is the pressure plate? It was somewhere here, right? Yeah. We can still make this.
Another skull crumbled to bits.
All right.
The gargoyle taps one stony claw upon its plinth as it rasps a message to you.
Riddle me this, wanderer. How would mighty Bracchus douse a man on fire?
Mm-hmm. Interesting.
Fire! It burns! It won't stop!
Hello. Okay. With more fire, I guess, to answer the question. So which skeleton is first? This one there. So let's make a save. They don't have any attacks of opportunity. So let's backstep them. Oh, there's another one.
Get back! Bracchus Vex has decreed none of you may approach him!
Okay. Why am I slowed?
Hurts, doesn't it?
Okay, he's done for. I'm going back outside. Perhaps I can use hit and run tactics for this one. I definitely need a break. And the door is open. So what the heck? So let's go outside. And I'm sneaking. Okay, Sibyl. Goes through the hedge. Nice. She will burn for 26 damage. This seems okay. So she can go here. Basically, run away a bit. And this guy will never see us. So I guess he will end his turn. Oh, he shoots over the wall. Alright. My turn now. What if I just sneak here? And then my turn. Okay. Get some restoration going. And then hide back there in the corner. Nice. Okay, because I'm burning, my sneaking will fail now and then. But this shouldn't be a problem. Oh, sneaking failed. Okay, then I'll go down here. Burning for two more rounds. Okay. My burning is gone away. Alright. And Sibyl has to endure it for some more. Alright. And I failed again. Well, then I'll move just here. Boop, and sneaking again. Okay, we are all sneaking now. So will this fight end eventually? Or what's the deal? Okay, let's have Sibyl heal up. I could bring this guy down here. Wait, I can turn myself invisible, which is probably more helpful. Yeah. Now he's not seeing me anymore. So hopefully the fight will end in a few rounds. That's weird. But through the power of teleportation gloves, I can get this guy and put him down there. And turn myself invisible. Okay, and walk back in. Since he can't see us both, yeah, he'll just stand there. And now I can go and backstep him merrily. Is he next? No, he's not next. Alright. I won't kill him, that's for sure. But I can turn him into a chicken now.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, this guy is going for a better position. So we have to be quick about it. Aloza needs healing, that's for sure. I want to kill this guy. Oh, shit. Another scroll of resurrection then. Okay, and we are back in game. Well, we just have to run from this archer, I guess. Yeah, he definitely can see us. We can hide behind this pillar. Okay. Now he is in the same state as the other guy before. I cannot teleport up there, but I can bring him down to us. But first I want to heal up. So I'm skipping some turns just to heal my characters. He saw me now, but that's not the problem. So what about teleportation? I guess I have to go there. Okay, and then I bring him down here. Let's make a save. And then I can just backstep jump in. And give me just one action point. But it's enough to attack him once more and then go invisible. So he cannot see anything right now. And now I'll come and start backstabbing him. That's how you fight, guys. Okay. And we're out of fight. Nice. So, we're already 35 minutes in, so I guess I'll end the episode here. We'll find the remaining two skeletons next episode. And I'll try and douse some of these fires off-cam. But GPO held up really good today. So, yeah. I hope you had some fun, and as always, I thank you for watching. See you on Monday. Bye bye.